Top of the hour, you're watching CNN. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Thank you for being with me. Jared Kushner is the media there. He just turned around and walked back in the West Wing. Now, as part of his meeting with the Senate Intel Committee, Jared Kushner submitted this 11-page statement that confirms he indeed had four contacts with Russians. So let's begin with all of this. Joining me now, CNN political. And Errol, just first to you. I mean, Jessica perfectly teed it up. He said in the 11-page statement, you know, reiterated it today in front of the White House, no collusion on behalf of myself or anyone in the campaign. We did find out about this previously undisclosed meeting with the Russian ambassador that had not been out there, hearing from Senator Ron Wyden, Democrat Oregon, saying, hang on a second, all this information we're getting actually brings on more questions than answers. How do you read today? Is this all right? Fulfilled his obligation, answer questions, move on?
No, not their innovation into the federal government. These two things cannot both be true at the same time.
I want to come back to your point on the email as well in a second. But to you, I mean, just reading your piece in January, the whole thesis was essentially, you know, Jared Kushner is more like the president than anyone realizes. And watching him today and this voice that no one could close their eyes and imagine what he sounded like, this mystique, as we discussed before the show came on, who is the real Jared Kushner?
I think
went on this whole email as one example, right? So we all know you get emails, you have items in your calendar, and apparently he just responded to Jared Kushner responded to, oh, I have a meeting Trump Tower with Don Jr. And according to Kushner, neglected to read the whole trail of the previous email chain on what was promised at said meeting. Apparently, you know, dirt on Hillary Clinton, which we reportedly came to not be, ignores the email subject line, which is essentially Russia, Clinton, private and confidential. And if you read the New York Times this morning, Frank Bruni said this. He got the emails about emissaries of a foreign adversary being to the assistant, hey, get me out of here 10 minutes in. How skeptical should staffers be up on Capitol Hill when you hear something like that?
Well, I mean, I think that there's are demanding his attention. So, you know, there's a slight internal
thing in a different sense.
Exactly. I mean, if you meet with the Russian ambassador,
a larger piece of this is we've been hearing, you know, Donald Trump and folks within the White House, you know, railing on the fake news media and these reports, fake news of, you know, people within the campaign or the transition team meeting with Russians. And, you know, yet you have out of his son-in-law's 11-page statement, you know, the opposite, essentially confirming that the fake news is fact.
Yeah, well, that's right. I mean, look, certain, we don't know if it's strategic, but the reality is one can clearly logically say, yes, he won. He flipped counties in Wisconsin from Obama to Trump. He won Michigan. He won Pennsylvania. He won the industrial Midwest. He won. He's the president. It's all legitimate. However,
there's at the same time, we're just trying to look at it from all perspectives. Just finally to you, does the public need to give Jared Kushner credit, as he and his lawyers have been promising for months and months and months that they would speak, maybe not to the public, but to, you know, the very important people up on Capitol Hill who are investigating on this Russia probe, that yes, he will sit and answer those questions. Yes, he's going back tomorrow. Do we give him credit?
Sure. I mean, I think
the security clearance, but now we know his version of events. So from here on out, if anything changes, we have a problem. Errol and Andrew, thank you so much on all things Jared Kushner. President Trump, once again, publicly, and Scott Jennings, former Bush advisor, on this whole Reince Priebus bit with Anthony Scaramucci last Friday, you know, referred to them as brothers from the podium. Today with Chris Cuomo on New Day, refers to them as brothers, but maybe Cain and Abel, and we know that didn't end so well for one of those brothers, Abel. How do you see this?
Well, I've been trying to digest this deluge of thing, particularly if the jobs news is part of what is in that stream.
But Trump is driving the conversation.
I will say that I think anybody who sees it like a full-hearted way that he wants this guy, I mean, everything suggests the opposite, that he wants the attorney general to leave so he can put somebody else in. The White House staff is feuding with each other, with the chief of staff.
In a real danger zone over the past week or so since he's been going after his attorney general, is he is encroaching on the conversation that is being had among the people who support him in the base.
Agree.
And you agree with that?
Yes.
And eroding that support by attacking Jeff Sessions, who he says he and Trump have a harmony of values and beliefs.
And that is a very important last line, the harmony of values and beliefs.
Andre Bauer, you've been waiting patiently. Let me come to you as well, just to bring your voice into this whole conversation, because, you know, again, the moment is here. After 7 years of campaign promises, Republicans have their chance to repeal and replace New fallout today from President Trump's tweets that transgender service members will be banned from the military. Defense sources tell you that the Navy also said it will not immediately discharge transgender sailors and they will still receive medical treatment. The military here suddenly finding itself on the defense from a president who once said this as a candidate. I'm Brooke Baldwin, Let's Send It to Washington. The lead starts now.